Hello, everybody. Welcome to Cigar Review TV. I'm your host, Damon Pettit, and today we are doing one of my favorite makers, one of my favorite actual brands, Avo. And it's an Avo Heritage cigar. There's the well-known classic Avo emblem. Very much looking forward to this. If you don't know much about Avo Eurasian, then take a little bit of time to get to know him as far as what he does, what he has done, and what he continues to do, especially for cigars. Trying to get a little music flowing, doing a little bit of contemporary jazz. I was trying to find I was going to actually use an album or CD or whatever you want to call it from Avo, but I wasn't able to download it quick enough or anything, so. Give this baby a light and see how it goes. I'm expecting very nice things. Very nice draw, as usual. Very, very nice. This baby is a Toro size. It's a 6x50. Very beautiful. Ecuadorian sun-grown wrapper. We have some filler of Pajero, some Peruvian. What else? There's got some Seco in there, I think. So let's see how this baby flows so far. As I lit it, very nice, just a very nice smell. Looks like I've got a collar up, but I don't. That's my seat. So, I'm not sporting the up collar, in case that's what you were thinking. Very beautiful out today. It is Thursday. Is it going to tell me on here? No. Thursday. It is May 30th, though. I do remember that. So, have it kind of turned around. It's a little bit lighter. It's not a night time. It is 8 o'clock. It's getting 20 minutes to 8. I am going to be enjoying my cigar with some coffee. It's a darker roast. Seattle's best darker roast. It's at the number 5. How they've decided to change their coffees like that. So far, this cigar, I don't know. Avo went from being just a musician, I believe, when did he come to the United States? Is it in the 40s? I believe it was 1947. He went to New York, and then he studied music at the, I can't remember the name of the, school. It's very famous. Come on. I'm trying to remember. Anyway, I'll think of Juilliard. The Juilliard School of Music. And he's just an incredibly accomplished artist. In one of my other reviews, I tell you the song. I believe I tell you the song that he wrote. Very, very, done some incredible things with music, but his cigars are just excellent, you know. And they're probably one of my favorite brands of cigars that have been out there for a long time. Just always great quality. I don't believe I've ever had one that I've been disappointed with. You can even get, because they're made in the Davidoff. Sorry, I'm kind of just looking at the, I'm never usually looking out this way, at least when I'm doing the review, so you can kind of see behind me and see the palm trees over there. There's my walls right here, some more palm trees, looking out over this way, beautiful sky right now. So anyway, I would have liked to have that in the background, but I can't get it so that my face can show. I know that it's so important to so many of you. I'm kidding. Very nice, nutty tones. A little bit dark vegetable in there, a dark green vegetable to me. If you're watching me for the first time, you're going, dark green vegetable? I don't think I want to try that. Don't just, you know, in the way I explain the cigar or whatever, that's just going to be my taste from the things that I eat. Let's say you eat just tons of cereal and meat, you know, you're going to probably have a different palate and you're going to taste a lot of different things. Let's say you've never had a cup of coffee in your life. You'll probably never say, oh, this tastes like coffee to me, because you don't know for sure if you've never had coffee. So those are the different things there with the tasting. So I just don't want to scare you off of any of these cigars by something that I say, you know, as far as green or anything else. It's just the way, what kind of something reminds me of. Beautiful, beautiful aroma comes from this cigar. Sorry, stuck my tongue out at you. I think I got it that time. Very beautiful draw on this cigar. Beautiful. I mean, just look at the color of that. I love that. I did not get this cigar at my regular tobacconist, which my favorite tobacconist out here. If you hear that screaming and stuff, there is a pool that's pretty close. So it's one reason why I'm trying to get the music in there. In a bit, but you know, whatever. Just we're all having a party. Just they're really going to town though, aren't they? My favorite tobacconist out here is Bastard Cigars, and they have a few, I believe, just two stores. He just only had the one for a really long time, and he's got another one. But so that, you know, if you're out here, it's definitely one of the best places to go to. There's a few others. Churchill's is another one. That those are my two favorite. And then this other one that I went to, it's a nice little lounge. It's really like a cigar lounge that you can go to. It's got a bar in it. But the prices on the cigars, you're kind of paying for their lounge, I believe, more than anything. So they're a little bit higher, about almost a dollar higher for this cigar. I bought this for $9.95 at this other cigar store. And then like a few days later when I was able to go to Ambassador's, I believe it was like right at $9 or $8.90 or something like that. So I was like, wow, you know, there's a little bit of a difference. So however much you pay for it, it's going to be depending on where you are, the store you are. I mean, you know, that's within the same state, there's a dollar difference, so. Coffee's pretty good. Had myself some honey liqueur over here as well, but I don't think it's going to end up, having that. Coffee's going to be good. Got some sirens in the background, some kids playing in the pool, some music, a little bit of life going on right now, huh? Anyway, I did have the pleasure of meeting Abbo, 10, a long time ago. It's pretty great. How time flies, it blows me away. It was like in 1998, I believe, 99. And, so, you know, however long ago that was. And he came into the cigar store, and I knew exactly. I mean, he had his white suit, his hat, and I was like, wow, he's just walking in. And he introduced himself, and I said, yeah, I know who you are. So he was a very nice guy, very, very mellow. You know, I didn't expect him to come in like a rock star, but it was just very nice. It was a very huge pleasure to meet him. And that was probably one of the, as far as meeting people, there were quite a few different celebrities that would walk in every now and then, but to me, that guy, I had the most respect for him out of everybody. Very nice. Very nice deep flavor in this cigar. Beautiful. Now I know I just said something about it. Now I'm afraid to say it because I think I'm going to be repeating myself. But I was talking about the quality of the Abbo cigars. And you can get Abbo seconds. They're usually labeled as a private stock cigar. And those are even excellent. And they're not ones that they consider good enough to put on the Abbo label. So they'll be just, you know, if you go into your store, they're actually called private stock, and then they're just numbered. So if you happen to see those, they're probably about $4, $5 maybe, half the price of what you'll pay for a regular one with an Abbo label on it, and give it a try. Definitely give it a try. I don't know, like, if all, I know that a lot of the bigger tobacconists carry those cigars, so, but I'm not exactly sure, like, you know, if, how they're allocated or any of that other stuff. I feel like screaming back. Just like, really tempted. Because they can't see me. I'm not gonna do that. I don't want to scare anybody. You're thinking, oh my god. I hope everybody's having a good week. It's June is coming up this week, isn't it? In a couple, not tomorrow, but the next day, I think. I think there's 31 days in this month. If not, then it's tomorrow. But it's Thursday. Day before Friday, everybody's kind of I have a different work schedule than other people do, so I usually have Sundays, Mondays off, what I do, and, you know, so my week is different, but I always think on Friday, you know, on Thursday, people are always kind of excited, you know, like tomorrow's Friday, you feel a little bit more relaxed, you feel like, oh, just, you know, you're gonna have this day and get through it, have a good time. I always kind of wonder, you know, how people think and how they feel about those different days. I just know for me, I always really enjoyed Fridays and Saturdays and Sundays. When I first came out here in Arizona, I didn't have a job. I just came out here, and luckily I was staying with my buddy Vince, and he let me rent from him. But I think the first month or two I didn't pay anything, which was very, very nice. Hopefully that's all it was. But anyway, the job I got was, I got through a temp agency, was working through, for, America West Airlines. They don't exist anymore, but, they were merged with somebody. Until it's starting to get darker, so I'm going to have to switch around here in a little bit. We'll do a pause, I think, and smoke a little bit, and then we'll come back to the light, to the usual angle that I'm at. I had the whole reason I'm telling you about this job and everything. I worked four 10-hour days. So I had a 3-day weekend every weekend. It was just great. I loved it so much. That was literally one of the coolest jobs because it was just all on the computer. I helped with aircraft maintenance stuff, and I just did like a lot of paperwork and weird little work. It wasn't hard. I really did the bulk amount of my work the first 2 hours I was there, and then the rest of the time was just really kind of not a lot of work. So that was actually just kind of a fun time being new out here and stuff like that. I don't think they could even hear me, to tell you the truth. It was just kind of spontaneous. I didn't even really mean to do that. Anyway. What we're going to do, I tell it's getting darker and darker. Pretty soon I'm just going to fade out. And you're just going to see my teeth as I talk. What I'm going to do is go ahead and pause it for now. I'm going to smoke it for a little bit. Be turned around, have the light on. See, if I turn the light on right now, then it'll be the opposite of what I was talking about before. You won't be able to see me. So, as the sun's going down, I'm going to turn things around. I'll be back. Hello, everybody. I'm back. Got the screaming kids and the music still. Hopefully, you can hear a little less of the pool people. We're having a good time, though. It's beautiful out, so they gotta take advantage of it before the water gets to be a boiling point. Still smoking this baby. It's got a little while to go. Fantastic flavor. I know that I said I bought it for $9.95, I think. And more than worth it. Like I said, I can get it at that other store for, I think, like a dollar less. And, this is the one I'm actually going to look, see if I can buy either, like, you know, a nice pack of or a whole box. If I get a whole box, I'm probably going to have to get another humidor, though, and, just kind of keep them in there. It's worth it. It's definitely worth it. They're very, very nice cigars. Always been pleased with them, with the different cigars that I get from, you know, that I have from Abbo, but this is excellent. It's fantastic. It's more of a, on the upper level, stronger medium-bodied cigar, but it's, there's no pepper to it. Lots of flavor. Lots of great flavor. And it's well worth it if you enjoy cigars. There you go. Little gecko friend is back. I see him over here. I haven't seen him for a couple weeks. I don't know if it's the same one, but it is. They just kind of squiggle when they walk. It's kind of funny. Actually, it's when they crawl, and they're crawling up the wall there. I'm going to come back in another few minutes. Smoke a little bit longer. We'll see. Great. Put that, but there we go. Trying to think if there's any other news. There are more tornado warnings in those, in actually Oklahoma again today, and I know there are some other states that are also involved in a lot of different bad storm warnings like that. So definitely always my thoughts are with you all out there, and hopefully everything's in doing well. Very glad that there's not been any worse things lately. Last few days, anyway. No, I'm not sure, but this song might be one of the songs that Abbo wrote. And I don't remember, but it seems so familiar. I know that, you know, that it's a huge song, but I'm just saying, I know that his songs are really, I can't remember though, I can't remember the song. This might not be it. Probably not. I did get a new bike. I don't know if I said that last. I don't think I said it last time, but finally got a new bike. I bought a used new bike. It's a Trek bike, but it's a much lighter bike, and it's such a difference to ride this thing compared to the other metallic piece that I. honestly, that other bike I had is so heavy. And just not a fun thing to ride a bike like that when you know that there's nice light bikes, you know. So definitely a different feel. But well worth it. Very much, very happy I got it. Oh my God. Well, I'll never know. There's two geckos now. They're actually chasing each other. I welcome those geckos because they keep scorpions away and different bugs. That's why we have what's called an ecosystem. That's why you don't want to kill a species off, because they are supposed to balance each other. Of course, the humans have to mess everything up in order to try to grow food and mass, you know, it's really messed up. I've never seen two here before, like, I've seen them in other places, but not just, like, on my porch, that's all. I'll probably, look up and be like, 1,000 of them up there. Then you'll hear me scream like a little girl. Like a little earlier. I'm gonna get another camera instead of using the phone, but I don't know. We'll see. I've tried to use so many different ones and the sound, you know. Like I'm experimenting again with this little one, but I'm gonna throw it in and see how the sound. I was recording the first half alongside this. And just to see if the sound comes out, what it's like. Cause if I remember right, can't hear shit with it. So more than likely, I won't use it ever for a video, this kind of video anyway. Doesn't have any kind of like a mic hook in, which kind of sucks. So I should probably just get like a real good camera. These geckos are staring me down. I think they're like grouping up and trying to kick me out of here, maybe. I don't know. Father's Day is coming up here. About 20 days, maybe. So, gonna get your the fathers in your life a little something something. I'm not an actual father, so I won't be getting anything, which is fine. I don't do the work of what a father does, at least good fathers. Ones that will get up and in the middle of the night, feed the kid, take turns with the mother, not just expect the mom to do all the work. Those of you out there that do that, that share that workload and help out, good job. That's exactly the way it's supposed to be. I mean, just having my little buddy here, my ex was my best friend, she's like my bestie. She's my roommate as well, but she had a baby 9 months ago, and watching a little baby grow up is pretty different. I never expected. I was always afraid of it, you know? And never really wanted to have a child or anything, but when you see what it's all about when you're like real close to it. Pretty cool deal. Pretty huge fucking miracle that any of us are still walking on this earth. All the little intricate things that could happen to you when you're a baby, that you could just die, you know, really easily. Little babies are so fragile, you know? I mean, when they're small enough, you know, baby could get smothered by a pillow on accident, you know? Or a blanket, or just all that kind of crap is just scary. I think that was one of the things I was always afraid of, is that some stupid thing like that would happen. You know, I've seen other things where a kid, die in the bathtub, just a little bit of water, because they slipped, hit their head, and little things like that, you know? So, us all being here smoking cigars and having other little babies and all this other stuff, it's a miracle. It really is. That's why I think when, you know, we cross over when we die, it's so, it's like so sudden. It's like, boom, all that you went through, all the shit that you did, all, you know, like, if you die as an adult or whatever, and especially if it's an accident, it's just like, boom, all that's, it's done. Okay, we're gonna finish up here, because it shut off on me there after a little bit, so we're gonna go ahead and finish up on this Avo Heritage Cigar, the Toro. Very, very nice cigar. I would recommend it to everybody, honestly. Just always very great quality, very good flavor. Always burns very nicely. Can't go wrong with it. So go out there and give it a try at least. And if you do, let me know what you think. I think you'll be very happy with them, to be honest with you. So, the night's very beautiful still. It is now 8:25 my time, Arizona time, on Thursday, the 30th of May. So I hope everybody's doing well. Hope everybody's smoking a fine cigar. And look forward to doing another review, hanging out with you. Blah, 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 blah. My little friend the geckos are still here. Thank you very much for clicking on me and watching. I know not everybody likes my things, and that's great. That's fine. Trust me, I understand. Just thank you for watching, and I hope you have an unbelievably great, fantastic day. Whatever day it is, whatever hour it is, just enjoy it. We're only here for a short time. Enjoy the fantastic flavors of life, with cigars, with drinks, with food, with water, with your families, with your friends. Even get together with an enemy once in a while, just to mix it up a little. Every now and then just scream like an idiot for fun. Alright, everybody. Thank you very much. Get yourself one of these Avo Heritage cigars. You will not be sorry. I promise you that. Thumbs up. Take care. I'll be seeing you soon.